Yo, what is up, you guys? Welcome back to the Latin Exotics YouTube channel on this beautiful but yet rainy Saturday morning. I believe that this upload is going to be going up on Saturday as well, so I believe that should be on point too. But check it out, I'm not kidding, the weather is actually dreadful. Look at this. To be honest, I would really not like to go outside there today. But that is the exact reason why I'm in here filming a YouTube video for you guys. As you've probably seen by the title, it's the 14th episode of the Aprilia SR50 rebuild, and this one's gonna be a bit of a choppier one for you guys. It has a lot of time jumps from point to point, and the time frame kind of doesn't make sense, but there's a whole lot of action going on, a whole lot of progress being made, so you'll just have to stick around and see what we get done in this video. If you enjoy these videos, as always, a friendly reminder to go down there and click that like button, click that subscribe button, and turn the noties on. And with that being said, without any further ado, let's get right into the video.
Frishy haircut. Sorry that you have to see me like this. Wait, I'm gonna go get a hat. All right, perfect. After layering the paint on a few parts, I'm still gonna have to go and hit them with clear coat. But right now, I'm gonna skip that process. I'm gonna do it a little bit later because what I have to do is something even more important, which is cleaning up the fairings because they have been sitting in the basement for quite a long time and have gotten pretty dusty. So I'm gonna go get those, clean those up, and then return to clear coating the rest of the metal parts that are left. And most likely, what I'm gonna have to do to source the paint, because I don't want to wait a month or 2 weeks or whatever how much the Radix of Riga told me I have to wait for, I'm gonna call the very trusty Radix of Yalga, and hopefully I can persuade them to send the paint over to me, because they usually don't have an online store and they don't have delivery. But I'm just gonna call them and tell me to write up a check, and I'm just gonna maybe even pay extra. I'm getting that paint no matter what, because I know they have it. Each and every single place has at least one or two of those paints, and I need at least two more. That being said, let's get to cleaning the fairings.
Need to tell a real one exactly what it is.
Everything would be fine and dandy, but there's one huge thing. I cleaned up all of the fairings, well, semi-cleaned up. I removed all of the bolts from them, all of the bolts, and I don't know what those are called. They are ready to be washed and cleaned. All these fairings are good enough, but there's one huge but. There is this fairing where there's stuff like this going on, which this is quite a bit of an issue. It's pretty bad. If I give him a fairing looking like this, I don't think he's gonna be very satisfied. Let's try to clean all this stuff. I cannot convince you that I love you for a living. I be on your live feelings flowing like a river. You be texting back, you a kiki on the river. Message say deliver, but I know that y'all don't get it. Why you introduce us if you knew that you was with him? Made me shake his hand, we all been fucking for a minute. Walk me off the plane because you know that I'm a swimmer. Supposed to be a dog, but you don't put me in. Now that I've got more or less all of these parts done, by the way, I didn't show you the parts that I managed to paint today. These, repainted those, that's painted, front shock, bracket, bars, subframe, exhaust. So there's actually not that much. I think I should fare well with two or three paint cans. I've got bracket, shock, spring, and rims. I'm gonna remove all of the tape from this frame, and I'm gonna go over all these parts with clear coats.
Need to tell a real one exactly what it is.
Yeah, this is the aftermath of removing all the duct tape from the frame. Currently, it's in an interesting state, but that's just temporary. It's gonna look fantastic when I spray it with clear coat, but before spraying it with clear coat, first step, wipe it down so that it is completely clean, and so that is what we're going to be doing right now. Now it's fully clean, as you can see. And now we're gonna begin the priming process, which is arguably the most important thing which I'm gonna have to do on this frame. We got the frame done. It looks super nice. It's got this super cool glossy sort of shine finish to it. I'm gonna take it with a flash so you can see it. It's all shiny with the flash on. I'm quite satisfied with how it turned out. Got these done, got this done also. Those two as well, that, this, and then this. Project is slowly but surely coming to a close. There are some annoying parts still left, like you already know, but Guys, I'm back. I actually added some more clear coat to the frame, so now it looks drippy. Then I added some more clear coat to the kickstand, more clear coat to the crankcase. I didn't add more clear coat to these parts because those already have enough clear coat. I switched up the spots where they're mounted to the ceiling and fixed up the areas where the paint hadn't gotten to. Soon I will be trying to start reassembling this whole rig together. But for right now, I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna go edit today's video, which is the 8th episode of the Aprilia SR50 build. Upload that, and then I might come back and maybe hit Home Depot once more, but I'm gonna have to clean up the garage as well. We're gonna figure out what we're gonna do today. I think I might reassemble the whole transmission and also calling it Adexialgo. I'm super excited about putting everything together. You can't even imagine.
I've had another huge revelation in the whole build thing. I don't get why they can't source the paint in Riga, but there's the Radex store in Jelgava. I call them, they say they have one of the cans in stock. And then I asked them, can I get any more? And they say, yes, of course. If you want more, we'll have them the next day, like tomorrow. Come here tomorrow afternoon and we'll have more cans. Why does the Riga store have to wait for week, 2 weeks, a month, but somewhere out in Jelgava, you get the paint in one day? Anyways, tomorrow, unplanned road trip to Jelgava to get paint and actually painting everything and getting all of the build done. I'm hopefully gonna start reassembling it tomorrow even. That's so cool. I know I haven't been here in a while and I haven't filmed anything, but I have made a lot of progress. I've actually got a moped here and it runs not very great, but I still need tuning and I actually need to do quite a bit of stuff to it. But I'm gonna show you what I have done in this long period of time and give you a brief update. Hopefully to you, it'll still be interesting to see what I have done here. So let's get into it. It's back here, it's standing on two wheels. I've got the new grips. I've got the exhaust redone. I've cleaned all of these fairings, so they look completely brand new. And you're probably wondering why I'm starting this in my bathroom. Well, it's because I'm gonna clean up the lights that I'm gonna be tinting. So wait, I'm gonna show you real quick. These are all the lights that I need to tint. Plus, I'm going to wrap these brake covers as well. I don't know if it's a good idea, but they look super ugly. So I wanna wrap those as well. I don't know if you guys saw or not. Maybe you did. It's on the Instagram. Go check out the gram, SR50 project, which sometime will be turning into the Latvian Exotics Instagram. But Starline Customs prepared some fantastic fairings for me. Shout out to him. I'm just gonna give you a quick glimpse before you can see anything. Look at that shiny thing. That's enough for the preview. I know that looks great and everything put together is gonna be fantastic. I still have to make a few minor adjustments on the paintwork from my side, but first let's start with tinting the lights.
Pray for my demons, girl, I got you. Every time I sip on codeine, I get vulnerable. Annoying the sounds of the storm when it comes. She understand I can't take her everywhere a nigga going. I've been in the field like the children of the corn. I can hear your tears when they drop over the phone. Get mad at yourself cause you can't leave me alone. Gossip, get messy, that ain't what we doing. Traveling around the world, over the phone, dropping tears.
These lights look pretty good. They have a little bit of a nick on this corner, which I won't be able to remove in any way. But for the purpose that I need them right now, they are very good. And everything else is clean and good. I just need to dry these and we'll be good to start tinting them. I will cut to that process right now.
I get more vulnerable when I do this. When you drunk, you tell me exactly how you feel. When I'm loaded, I keep it real.
I wrapped one of the brake cylinder covers and it doesn't look too bad. I will cut these excess thingies off. I'm gonna attempt to do the second one, then I'm probably gonna redo this one because it was just a test run, so I've never really wrapped anything before.
It don't even matter what time it is. I will wait for you. President Roller, RM, wait.
And I actually did the second one quite well. I have to trim the outer edges, but other than that, it went together super well. Dang. These projects are a lot of trial and error, but you have to get it perfect. So that's why we are redoing this one.
I know there was most likely a pretty huge cut from the last video that I filmed, which was, I believe, tinting the lights or whatever, which I didn't even tint in the way that I intended to. And I'm sorry for that, but the main thing is that we are back and we are continuing to finish up the project. You haven't seen a lot of it since I've been doing it by myself. Since summer's out now, I have a bit more time and I am ready to get back into it. So look what I got here. I've got this pipe, which I did a cinematic scene for in the SR50 Instagram page. If you're interested in that, you can go check that out. But it is a Stage 6 R1400. Yes, it is used, but it's very top quality. It has this mount broken, but we have an extra mount. But for now, take this to the garage and I'll see you there and show you the updated scooter and talk about the checklist which we have to complete in order to get it done, because we are not far from having it being done. Well, how was that for an episode? I understand that the time frame was very skewed in it and that a whole lot of the build did actually get skipped, but there is a valid reason for that. Well, actually, probably not. It was that I wanted to get everything built faster at the time, and now looking back at it, I know that I should have probably filmed a lot more, and I regret not filming a lot more of the build process because that's probably the most interesting part to you guys. But there were a lot of issues that I faced and I really didn't feel like filming because there were a lot of things that I was doing for the first time when rebuilding. Like, for instance, I had issues with getting the brakes to work, and I also had a few issues with setting up the electricals and just a lot of minor things because of my perfectionist nature, and I decided that I want to focus on the build myself rather than film everything, which, yes, as I mentioned before, I do regret and I do apologize a lot for that. But beside all that, thank you for sticking out to the end of the video. I hope you did enjoy. We're gonna continue this series because, as you can see, everything is nowhere near done yet and it still has a lot of small details to get done. It still has to be tuned. The ignition timing is off. And of course, I gotta give you the final ride and a showcase and all of the budget that actually went into making a project like this, so you guys would know what you would be approximately looking at if you would want to do a build like this as well. But with that being said, as always, I gotta remind you to go down there and click the like and subscribe button, as well as turn the noties on. Thank you for taking time out of your day to tune back into the Latin Exotics YouTube channel and enjoy my videos. It honestly means the world to me, and we're on the road to 100 subscribers, so if you could click that subscribe button, I would appreciate that a lot, because look at this graph. There's already a huge reason why you should click the subscribe button if you enjoy my videos. And now I'll finally stop bugging you to boost my engagement on my channel. Appreciate you guys a lot, and I will see you in the next upload. I keep a pretty bitch put up. Ride through with a chauffeur, I be chilling with my foot up. Niggas all cap bullshit, niggas pull up. Master P in 98, that little nigga got the hook up. I'ma make a drop of jaws every time a nigga pull up. Drop it, drop it, drop it, drop it. Every time you turn around, that nigga, he the top. You would think the baby popcorn the way the nigga pop.